Hello friends, welcome to CivilFit. In this video, we are going to see about some important MCQs of building materials, especially in the topic of bricks. We already know in all the AE and JEE exams, building materials contains more than 10 to 12 marks, especially the topic of bricks contains 2 to 3 marks. Let's see some of the important MCQs in the topic of bricks in this video. Follow us on Facebook and Instagram. And join our Telegram group and WhatsApp group for daily quizzes in all the subjects. What is the nominal size of the standard brick as per Indian standards? The answer is 19x9x9. If it is asked the nominal size, if they didn't mention any Indian standard, means the answer may be 19x9x5 also. If they ask in the question with mortar joints means, and the answer will be 20x10x10 or 20x10x5 cm. The percentage of silica in a good brick earth lies between 50 to 60%. If they ask for alumina means, the answer is 20 to 30%. Once again, listen, silica means 50 to 60%, alumina means 20 to 30%. The next question is, which of the following defect appears due to the presence of alkalis in the bricks? The answer is efflorescence. Black ore means it is formed due to the improper burning. Bloating means it is a spongy woolen moss over the surface of the burned brick. The presence of excess carbaceous matter and sulfur in the brick cake causes the bloating. We already know presence of alkali means efflorescence. Presence of carbonaceous material means bloating. If the brick is not burnt well means, then it is called black ore. The process of mixing clay, water and other ingredients to make the brick is known as kneading. Pugging means the process of grinding the clay with water and making it a plastic. That means making the earth or clay material to the plastic state is called pugging. Molding means making the clay earth or brick earth material to the perfect shape. That is, brick shape is called as molding by using the hand mold or machine molding. The manufacture of the bricks contains four methods. First one is preparation of clay or brick earth. Second one is molding. Third one is drying. And fourth one is burning. The first process, preparation of brick or earth, contains totally six steps. The first is that we should select the places and unsoil the places. That means we should remove the impurities and organic present in the topsoil up to the depth of 20 cm. Second step is digging, that is leveling. Third step is cleaning. Cleaning means cleaning the clay which is free from stones, pebbles, vegetable matters, etc. And lumps of the clay should be reduced to the powder form. Next we are going to do the weathering. Weathering means the leveling, that means spreading the cleaned earth or the clay materials to 60 to 120 cm thick layers for the exposure of weathers for few months. Next we are going to do the blending. Blending means it is a mixing of the brick earth material, water and other ingredients to form a good brick earth material. Next one is tempering. Tempering means we are cutting, that means by using the cattle or men, we should press the brick or the clay materials to compact and dry it slowly. Now we are going to see about the presence of alumina. We already know the brick should contain 20 to 30% of alumina. The excess alumina causes the cracking of brick. The next one is excess silica. We already know silica should be present up to 50 to 60%. More than 60% of silica causes brittle and makes the brick to the weaker conditions. Next, excess of lime. Excess of lime causes the brick to melt and dissolve during burning. Now we are going to see about the water absorption conditions. For the first class brick, it should not be more than 20% of its dry weight. For second class brick, it should not be more than 22% of its dry weight. Third class brick, it should not be more than 25% of its dry weight. These 6 points are very, very important in all the MCQs. That means all the exams, it is repeatedly asked for questions. The compressive strength of the first class brick is 10.5 Newton per mm squared. It is also called as variable bricks. If the compressive strength of the brick is 7 Newton per mm squared means, then it is called second class brick or it is called grade B bricks. If the compressive strength is 14 and above 14 means, then it is called grade AA bricks. We shall discuss some of the points in the compressive strength of the bricks. The first is the compressive strength of any individual brick shall not be less than an average value as specified above by 20%. If the brick has a compressive strength less than or equal to 3.5 Newton per mm square means, then it is called grade C bricks or it is called as third class brick. These are some important things to be remembered while studying about bricks. The first thing is the burning of the bricks in the kiln is for about 24 hours. The temperature on which the brick should burn is 1000 to 1200 degrees Celsius. The third point is after molding, brick should be dried in the air for 3 days. It should not be dried in the sun. It should be dried in the pure air. Thank you for watching our video. For more video, subscribe our channel. Follow us on Facebook, Instagram, Telegram and WhatsApp. Join our WhatsApp and Telegram group by using the link that is given in the description. We are conducting quizzes in Facebook, Instagram and Telegram. Please attend those quizzes and follow us. Especially in Telegram, we are conducting subject-wise quizzes. Each subject contains 30 questions. Every day at 4 p.m. we are conducting the quizzes. So join our Telegram and attend free mock tests for all the exams. Thank you.